The last state became the first state to commit to 100% clean energy. This morning, the governor signed a law requiring all of Hawaii's electricity to be produced from renewable energy sources by the year 2045. That means no more fossil fuel. So we'll have to rely on solar, wind, geothermal, and other clean energy sources. Bridget Namata is digging deeper and finds out how this will affect you. Bridget.
Yes, Hawaii is going green, Marissa and Dash. The state's time frame is lenient, 30 years to turn completely green. Supporters say it could take some getting used to, but it will save customers millions of dollars in the long run.
History was made today as Governor Ige committed Hawaii to end its dependence on imported fossil fuel.
It wasn't too long ago that Hawaii was virtually 100% imported fossil fuel. And clearly, we have made significant progress.
We're raising the bar globally for what's possible, and we should do it in Hawaii. Hawaii has all of the resources, and we have no fossil fuel, yet we're so dependent on imported fossil fuel, which costs us billions every year.
Blue Planet CEO Jeff Michelina says Hawaii has the highest electricity rates in the nation. He believes moving towards clean energy will result in plenty of benefits.
What it means in the long term is lower energy bills, more stable energy bills, likely more local jobs. We're shifting that money from buying fossil fuel and shifting it into local investment and local labor.
Michelina is not sure what the transition will look like, but Hawaii has 3 decades to figure it out.
We're going to have more energy sourced locally, and that means wind farms, solar farms, perhaps things like offshore wind. But it's a conversation that we need to have together as a community. Where's the right place to put these things, and how can we best balance, you know, the cost, the location, impact to the environment?
HECO released a statement saying the proposed merger with NextEra would help make the state's goals a reality. President Alan Oshima says it's what HECO's been working toward. With a diverse portfolio of renewable energy resources and strong, upgraded electric grids.
The new laws also make it possible for 3 other things. A task force to study hydrogen as a fuel source, setting a net zero energy goal for the University of Hawaii. Finally, the law will give more people a chance, like renters or condominium owners, to benefit from solar energy. Bridget Namata, KHON2 News.